2013. Sorry I haven't made any videos lately. I've been working for a living. Oh wait, no, that's not that. No, got my own company. Okay, pretty good. Anyway, enough of that. I asked my friend, what does he think I should cook? And he said, hey man, fry up some sheep's head. I said, sheep's head? Sounds good, because I just caught two big sheep's head about that big. And I had a whole ice chest of fish, and I put the sheep head in the food saver, froze them with some black drum. Let me just show you. So that's what I got out of a good sized sheep head. See that? This is fresh out of the freezer. But these are some nice chunks of real nice white meat. And we got some black drum up in there too. So what we're gonna do, he said fry them, and I said, sounds good. I'm not only gonna fry them, I'm gonna make poor boys. Fried sheep head and fried drum poor boys. So, let's get started. Been a while, man. All right. Measuring cup, Louisiana Gold hot sauce. Shake it up, put some in the measuring cup, about that much right there. If you can get any, this is good stuff, but if you can't get it, use whatever they have. Get you a piece of fish. Oh, this black part, this dark part right here, kind of cut it out like a V. Just kind of take your fillet knife, kind of run it down there. That's what we call bloodline. So you just take your knife and just slice it. There you go. See, that's pretty much bloodline. This is a very, very strong flavor. You can still deep fry this and give it to your Cajun neighbors and they won't really know the difference. That's a joke. Anyway, here's a piece of fish right here. I might have to, I think it'll fit in my fryer. Nah, I'm gonna probably have to cut it right about like that. So I want long pieces that are gonna lay it together on the poor boy. See, there's a scale right there. It won't hurt nothing. So then you take these, drop them in there, put a little more, drop the next one in there, so on and so forth. So what I'll do the rest of these off the camera. Then we'll proceed to the next step. What I'm going to use is plain old Zatarain's fish fry, crispy southern. It's a lot cheaper than me buying a bag of cornmeal and flour and the spices. And I found this today, mayonnaise with spicy buffalo hot sauce in it. And I'm going to squeeze that on the poor boys. So, should be good. It's got to be good. All right, what you're going to do, you got them in there. Just going to spin them all around. Make sure that all sides get the hot sauce on them. By the way, this was technique was showed me by Billy Lanza from New Iberia. Okay. And Alex Ortiz, thanks, man, for the heads up on what to cook. Appreciate it. So there they are. Pretty much just fish, Louisiana hot sauce. In this particular case, Louisiana Gold. But this really gives a good flavor, and it helps for the fish fry to catch up to adhere to the meat. So let me get a pan, and we'll get the oil hot and get.
I barely put the oil in here.
It's gonna take a while, but let's go ahead and bread some of these up. Just get them, lay them on there. As such, I used all of it because I don't care. I don't like saving stuff. It just clutters up the house. That's what she said. Flip them over. Don't be shy. Get it all over there. They're gonna be good, man. It's got to be good. And just set it over here on the side. Okay. See that? Set them over there. Get some more, do the same thing. Shake them off before you lay them in there. As such. Same thing, different side. There you go. These were caught south of Bob Hall Pier on the coast, Gulf of Mexico coast, Texas. I don't remember what day it was, but about a month ago. So they're fresh. Fresh enough. There we go. Couple more yet. This could be more than enough for the poor boys, so. Poor boy. Big old, about 2 foot long pole boy. This is gonna be a killer. Same thing. Try not to spill that. Oh, too late. We'll pay for that later. Oh, yeah. So what happens when you have to work one-handed because you don't want to block the camera view? There we go. Good enough. It's easier just to buy the fish fry, folks. Saves a lot of time. There's nothing wrong with cooking conveniently. You know, save more time to eat and to go fishing and work. Clean house. Yeah, right. No. Sometimes. That's the last two pieces right there. Let them sit. Just like this. There. Get it all in all the nooks and crannies too if you can. This will, I guarantee deliciousness on this stuff. I guarantee. You know how I know? Because I've done this before many times, but I want to share with you good folks out there in TV land, computer land, that is. Maybe someday I'll be on TV. I don't want to be. This is just a hobby. Anyway, when the oil gets hot enough, I'll be right back and we'll drop them in. Right, folks, the oil's up to temp. We're going to now proceed in dropping these fishies into the hot oil. Ooh, that was close. Almost got my finger. One and two. I don't want to put too many in at once because I want them to stay flat. So we'll go ahead and fry that. I don't know if you really care about what you're seeing right now, but you know, it's okay. This is another view. Kind of take a zoom in so you can see it. There you go. The oil is 375 degrees Fahrenheit with a molecular biology capacity of 0.057, which actually helps the oil adhere to the inner layers of the fish. Yeah, right. Sound like I'm in college again or something. No, we're just doing old school deep frying. 375, of course, you drop the cold fish in there, the temp's going to drop a little bit, so don't worry about that. That's why you don't put too many in there also, it'll drop the oil too much. See how they look? Don't bring them all the way out, just kind of, bam, lift them up, boom. I want them real dark, dark, golden brown. That's what I'm looking for. So, they're almost ready. I'm only going to show you this part of it. I believe I don't want to bore you with the deep frying of fish, because we have another process. The garnishing of the po' boy. You're gonna really like this po' boy. Alright, let's take them out, see what we've got. Golden brown, see folks? Golden brown, you can see in there. If you can't, then put it in 1080p, you'll be able to see it better. Alright, that's about it. Now let me do the rest. Alright, here's the last two. Nice and semi-golden brown. Put them in there. Ended up with quite a bit of fish. Enough for po' boy, for me. Anyway, these are sweet potato fries. We're gonna make some of those too. So what I'm gonna do is keep this up, drop them in there like that. And I'm gonna load it up about that much right here. Probably cook the whole thing. Nah, I don't know. I don't wanna get carried away. Anyway, there's your sweet potato fries, folks. You always wanted to know what those were all about, now you know. Let's take a zoom in on this fishies. There you go. I got a lot. It's a lot here. It's enough for probably 10 Cajuns and maybe 2 Texans. That's messed up. You know what I mean.
Be back.
Alright, the sweet potato fries are pretty much fried. I'm just going to make one batch, folks, because we're going to be carved out enough with the bread. Anyway, there we have it. Let me get out the, you can see it over there already, kind of interesting. Alright, I'm going to set up this little preparation table here, and we're going to start garnishing and loading up all kinds of goodies.
Okay,
all
folks,
right, be back. Here we have the Texan po' boy. We're going to, for convenience, we're going to cut it right about here. Alright. Then, we have to cut it to fit those big pieces of fish. We have to cut it right down the middle. All the way through, too. Because I'm serious, you know. I might have taken a while to make a video, but when I make one, y'all will be ready. Don't ask me what kind of bread this is, because I don't know. I just grabbed it off the shelf. I'm not into all that certain kind of stuff. I just know it's bread, and it looks good, and I'm hungry, and that's all I can say. All right, bread, fish over there, garnish over here. So what we're going to do, we're going to get these out of the way a little bit. I'm sure y'all can see. Can you see? Yeah, if you can't, too bad. Bread. Fishes. Take a piece of fish. Lay it on the bread. Take another piece of fish. Lay it on the bread. Another piece of fish. Lay it on the bread. And actually let them kind of overlap, because we're going to put another piece of fish right here. There you go. Alright. Get you some lettuce. Lay it on the fish. Fish kisses. Fish, lettuce, fish. Meet each other. How much lettuce do you guys like? Like that? Tomatoes. You like tomatoes, everybody? I do. And last but not least, the stuff that hasn't been opened yet that I should have opened. That I'm going to have to pause the camera.
Right,
didn't take long at all, did it? This is Hellman's Spicy Buffalo. Let's just kind of run it on down here. I could have made my own sauce, but I said, you know what, I'm going to try this. Looks good. Ta-da! And you just lay this back on chair like that. And what do you have? You have an awesome sheephead drum po' boy. What do you think about that, folks? Get a zoom in on there for you, since you're so attentive. Oh yeah. I'm getting hungry. Well, let me eat this in front of you and let you know how good it isn't. It is. It's got to be good, man. So, let's do that.
Alright. Here comes the fun part. I'm going to take a paper towel and wrap this thing. Because it's gigantic. I don't want to lose any of the ingredients. Because it's gigantic, that's all I can say. I'm not in view right now because I'm fitting to get in position to eat this. Here you go, folks. The Surfin' Sapo Fish Poor Boy. Sheephead and drum. Let's try her out. Nick Meyer would say, it's lovely. Sweet potato pie. They're always good. I want to show you something else, too. Okay?
Gotta aim down.
It's not what you think it is. You're gonna like it. You see that? Right there. It's called South Texas Pomp Hunters. It's a club we have. A bunch of Pompano fishermen. And on the back, this is a... Can you see that? Let's see, right there. Chang Fest 2013, it already passed. It was a barbecue at the beach. And me and a bunch of my friends would go out there to the beach. And we have these campouts and fishing and cooking and all that. It's pretty fun. We'll have another one in the fall called Pomp Fest. So, that's about it. This video is now fitting to be over, and I'm fixing to eat. And I gotta make the other one for the other Texan in there. The Tejana, the Texan girl, the shrimper's daughter, whatever. Huh? No. Alright, folks. I'm gonna zip it while I'm ahead. God bless you. Tight lines. Keep cooking. Thanks for subscribing, all you new people. I check it out. I've just been very busy. And thanks for the guy that told me that I was making the grape leaves wrong. Thank you. I'll reverse them and put the other, you know, backwards. They still taste good, but thanks for correcting me. I'm not a professional cook. I'm just having fun, okay? All right. Adios. God bless. Gloria a Dios.
That is French for the rest of it. Red is the color of peppers, the hot peppers that we pick. My mama makes a mean hot sauce that keeps it locked up in the shed. One night the lock was big when I catch that cookie stick. Now who stole the hot sauce? Who stole the hot sauce? When I catch that crook, he'll drink every drop he took. Like a dog love a bone, like a fish love the sea, like a squirrel love a nut. That's what that hot sauce mean to me.
I put it on my eggs
and on my beans and rice too. I just can't do without it. I gotta get it back from you.
Now who stole the hot sauce? Who stole the hot sauce?
When I catch that crook, he'll drink every drop he took.
Thank you.
white is French for the red stick. Red is the color of peppers, the hot peppers that we pick.
My mama makes a mean hot sauce.
Keep it locked up in the shed. One night the lock was picked when I guess that crookie's dead.
Who stole the hot sauce? Who stole the hot sauce?
When I catch that crook, he'll drink every drop he took.
Who stole the hot sauce? 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 Who stole the hot sauce?